إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم warned us towards the end of times about misguidance and deviation that will occur in this ummah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, سيأتي على الناس أو ستأتي على الناس سنوات خداعات. They will come upon this time, upon this ummah, upon the nation, upon the people, years which are deceptive. يصدق فيها الكاذب. The one who is a liar will be considered to be the one who is truthful. ويكذب فيها الصادق. And the one who is truthful will be considered to be a liar. وَيُؤْتَمَنُ فِيهَا الْخَائِنُ. And in those times, the one who is a deceiver, he will be trusted. وَيُخَوَّنُ فِيهَا الْأَمِينُ. And the one who is truthful and is trustworthy will be considered to be someone who is deceitful and not trustworthy. And in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, وَيَنْطِقُ فِيهَا الرُّوَيْبِضَةَ. And the ruwaybida, they would speak. And so the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they didn't understand something, they would ask. And so they said, who are these ruwaybida? Many ruwaybida? Who are these ruwaybida? What are they? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, who is this man, these people who start speaking? هو الرجل التافه يتكلم في الأمر العام. He is a man who is tafih, and he is nothing amongst his community. He is not a scholar in knowledge. He is not a person of influence. He is not someone who is considered to have any value in the society, but he's been given the platform to speak about anything and everything. يتكلم في الأمر العام, speaks about everything. This is something the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us about in this ummah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us again as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, he said, هذا صراط ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه. He said, خط رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لنا خطا. The Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام drew a line in the sand. And then he drew lines on the side of each of that straight line. And then he said, هذا سبيل الله. This is the path of Allah. وهذه السبل. And these are the other paths. على كل شيء على كل سبيل منها شيطان يدعو إليه. Upon every single path, there is a shaitan calling to that path. And then he recited the ayah, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. This is the path of Allah, so follow that path of Allah, and do not follow these other paths, and so it will misguide you and take you away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني المجاهد ابن جبر المكي رحمه الله تعالى, he said, these subul, these paths, are الشبهات والبدع, innovations in the religion, new things in the religion. Meaning these paths are not just paths of desires. Someone wants to go and commit a sin. No, these paths are paths of people who will call to a religion other than the religion of Islam whilst they're quoting themselves with Islam. But they're calling to other than Islam. And so he said, this is the path of Allah. And so Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام warned us in many, many hadith about these paths that will be called to, and they will be quoted in Islam, but they're not really Islam. Innovations, newly invented matters in our religion that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never did and never knew. That the companions, they never did and they never knew. And he guided us to the way to be guided to the straight path. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us in a hadith that this ummah will split up into 73 groups. Every single one of them will be in the hellfire except for one. Who are they? Look at the way of salvation. How can we be saved? He said, "Man kana ala mithli ma ana alayhi al-yawm wa ashabi." Whoever is upon what I am upon and my companions. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his way. So the first thing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about, that he told us for us to stay firm upon this religion, so that we die and we meet Allah azza wa jal upon a religion that is the one that Allah is pleased with, not nothing else. The first thing that he guided us is to the Quran of Allah azza wa jal, holding on to the Quran. Ali ibn Abi Talib is narrated from Ad-Darimi and Ad-Tirmidhi and others. They narrated that Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, "Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul." I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, "Ala innaha satakunu fitan." There will come times there are going to be fitan, trials and tribulations in a person's religion. His religion will be snatched away from him. فَقُلْتُ عَلِي بْنَ أَبِي طَالِبْ said, مَا الْمَخْرَجُ مِنْهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. O Messenger of Allah, how do we get out of these traps, of this fitan? قَالَ he said, كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. Hold on to the book of Allah. Hold on to the book of Allah. فِيهِ نَبَأُ مَنْ مَا كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. In the Quran, there is the news of the people before you. وَخَبَرُ مَا بَعْدَكُمْ. And there is the news of the people that was going to come after you. وَحُكْمُ مَا بَيْنَكُمْ. The Quran is what decides between you. Don't let your desires, when it comes to money, you don't want to go to the Quran. When it comes to family issues, go to the Quran. When it comes to your deen, what do I believe about Allah Azza wa Jal? Go to the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَحُكْمُ مَا بَيْنَكُمْ وَهُوَ الْفَصْلُ لَيْسَ بِالْهَزَلِ. It is the thing that distinguishes clearly, and it is not a joke. مَنْ تَرَكَهُ مِنْ جَبَّالٍ قَصَمَهُ اللَّهِ. Whoever leaves off the Quran out of oppression, arrogance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will break him. وَمَنْ ابْتَغَى الْهُدَى فِي غَيْرِهِ أَضَلَّهُ اللَّهِ. Whoever seeks guidance in other than the Quran. They say the Quran is not enough. مَنْ ابْتَغَى الْهُدَى فِي غَيْرِهِ أَضَلَّهُ اللَّهِ. Allah will make him misguided. وَهُوَ الصِّرَاطُ وَهُوَ حَبْلُ اللَّهِ الْمَتِينَ. It is the rope of Allah, the strong rope of Allah. وَهُوَ الذِّكْرُ الْحَكِيمُ. And it is the reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. It is the straight path. هُوَ الَّذِي تَزِيغُ لَا تَزِيغُ بِهِ الْأَهْوَاءُ. It is the one, the Quran, that cannot be deviated or changed because of people's desires. The Quran, it gives you the ruling. No one's desires can change the Quran. وَلَا تَلْتَبِسُ بِهِ الْأَلْسِنَةُ. And the tongues, they don't find it hard to recite. So whether you're Arab or non-Arab, you can recite the Quran. وَلَا يَشْبَعُ مِنْهُ الْعُلَمَاءُ. The scholars, they never get full of the Quran. وَلَا يَخْلَقُ عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الرَّدِّ. And it does not become boring when you repeat it again and again and again. وَلَا تَنْقَضِي عَجَائِبُهُ. The Quran, the amazing things of the Quran never finish. هو الذي لم تنتهي الجن إذ سمعته حتى قالوا إنا سمعنا قرآنا عجبا. Is the Quran, when the jinn they heard it, they said we heard an amazing Quran. يهدي إلى الرشد. It guides to the straight path. يهدي إلى الرشد. فآمنا به. And so we believe in it. من قال به صدق. Whoever says with the Quran, he's truthful. ومن عمل به أجر. And whoever acts by the Quran is rewarded. ومن حكم به عدل. And whoever judges by the Quran, then he has been just. وَمَنْ دَعَى إِلَيْهِ هُدِيَ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. And whoever calls to the Qur'an, then he has been guided to the straight path. So the Qur'an of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hold on to the Qur'an. Someone says to you, this is halal. Ask, is it in the Qur'an? This is haram. Is it in the Qur'an? Is it in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And that's number two. The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We've become, that's the second way of salvation. How a person should be saved. That they follow the sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet Allah azza wa jal told us in the Quran, مَنْ يُطِعُ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Whoever obeys the Messenger, then he has obeyed Allah. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave you, then hold on to it. And whatever he prohibited you from, then leave it off. The Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. If you really love Allah, then follow me. Follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah will love you and Allah will forgive your sins. The Messenger of Allah, the one who said, لَا أُلْفِيَنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ, let me not find any one of you. يَتَّكِئُ عَلَىٰ أَرِكَتِهِ, you're relaxing in your chair. فَيَأْتِيهِ أَمْرٌ مِّنْ أَمْرِي, one of my commands it comes to you. You hear the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, don't be like this person. This man, he says, مَا وَجَدْنَاهُ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ اتَّبَعْنَا, whatever we find in the Quran, we follow. As for the Sunnah, they say we don't follow. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, don't be like that. He said, أَلَا وَإِنِّي أُوتِيتُ الْقُرْآنَ وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ, I was given the Qur'an and similar to the Qur'an with it. Meaning I was given the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is wahy from Allah. Just like the Qur'an is revelation from Allah, the Sunnah is revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to follow the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Someone says, go and worship Allah in this way. We ask, is that in the Qur'an? Did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam worship Allah in this way? من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا, whoever does an action and we haven't commanded it, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فهو رد, is rejected. You do an action, you want to get closer to Allah, you think you can do something that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do, and you think you'll get closer to Allah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قد بلغ الرسالة, he sent the message fully. There's nothing left that you can add on, me and you we can add on. So what should we do in that case? اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا. Follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and don't add something new. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله هو الحق المبين. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ما بعد, فاتقوا الله عباد الله. My brothers and sisters, the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us to the solution to be saved يوم القيامة. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. The day when your wealth, your money is not going to benefit you. Your children are not going to benefit you. Except for who? The one who comes to Allah with a clean heart. Clean from shirk, clean from innovation, clean from sins of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran number one. The Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam number two. And there's one third thing. One third thing that every single one who wants salvation, everyone who wants to be saved from the hellfire, everyone who wants to be successful, they need it. Allah said in the Quran, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازْ. Whoever is saved and made far away from the hellfire and is entered into Jannah, then he's going to be, that is the one who is successful. The Quran and the Sunnah number three, my brothers and sisters, that we follow the Sahaba of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did they understand the Quran? Is it the way that me and you we understand? No, it's the way that the Sahaba and the early generations, the way they understood the Quran, the way they understood the Sunnah, that's the way we're going to be saved. Don't meet Allah yawm al-qiyamah and you have an evil belief in your heart. You have a belief against the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اهْتَدَوْا. If you believe in what they believe, then you're guided. And Allah said in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Whoever opposes the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he follows other than the way of the believers. Who's the believers? The companions. You follow other than the way of the companions. There came a group of people at the time of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, and they would say that there is no qadr of Allah. We don't believe in the qadr of Allah. Wal-iyadu billah. We don't believe in the qadr of Allah. Al-amru unuf, they would say. Things happen and Allah did not know about it. What did Abdullah ibn Umar say about them radiallahu anhu, Sahih Muslim? He said, when you meet them, فَأَخْبِرْهُمْ, tell them, أَنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْهُمْ وَأَنَّهُمْ بُرَآءٌ مِّنِّي. Tell them that I'm free from them and they are free from me. Abdullah ibn Umar, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They deviated away from the companions, and so they and they said, and tell them that if they were to spend the mountain of Uhud in gold, they gave charity, a mountain of gold in charity. ما قبله الله منهم. Allah will never accept it from them حتى يؤمنوا بالقدر, until they believe in the qadr of Allah. They say they're Muslims, لكن they went against the way of the companions. At the time of the Sahaba, again another group, they came and they went to a place in Iraq, and the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were there, and they were in a place called Harura. The Khawarij, and they would say, we are the ones who follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As for the companions, they're kuffar. That's what they would say. Are they going to be guided? Abdullah ibn Abbas, the companion radiallahu anhu, I came to them. Ali ibn Abi Talib sent Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said to him, لَقَدْ جِئْتُكُمْ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. I came to you. I've seen there's 4,000 of them. I've come to you from the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَمَا فِيكُمْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدٍ. And I don't see any companion amongst you. The companions who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praised, they said Uthman fil Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said Uthman, Abu Bakr fil Jannah, wa Umar fil Jannah, wa Uthman wa Ali fil Jannah. Ali is alive. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said Ali is in Jannah. They say no, Ali is not in Jannah. They followed other than the way of the companions. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, and Allah azza wa jalla told us, "Wa man yushaqiq ar-rasul." Whoever opposes the messenger and follows other than the way the companions, what's the punishment? نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى. We're going to leave him to follow whatever he wants to follow. What's the punishment after that? وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمِ. He's going to burn in the hellfire. وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. What an evil abode. So when مَنْ مَخْرَجُ. What's the way out? Oh brothers and sisters, what's the way out? What's the way to be saved? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told, مَنْ كَانَ عَلَى مِثْلِ مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمُ وَأَصْحَابِي. Whoever's upon what I'm upon today are my companions. If someone says to you, this is halal, haram, this is the formula, brothers and sisters, I'm giving you a formula to salvation, to be saved. Quran, is it in the Quran? Alhamdulillah. Is it in the Sunnah? Alhamdulillah. Did the companions, the Salaf, the Sahaba, did they understand this the way you understood it? Yes. Alhamdulillah, then follow it. Is it in the Quran? No, then don't follow it. Is it in the Sunnah? No, then don't follow it. طيب, is the Quran in the Sunnah? Did the Sahaba understand it the way you understood it? No. The Sahaba, they said this. This person said something else. They're both using Quran. Who do we follow? We follow the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ. My brothers and sisters, this life is short, and the Akhirah is in front of us. And whoever is saved from the hellfire, then that's the one who's successful. So follow this formula that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us, and inshaAllah ta'ala will be successful. ثم صلوا وسلموا على سيد المرسلين وإمام المتقين كما أمركم الله تعالى به إذ قال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على عبدك ورسولك نبينا محمد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعنا معهم بفضلك وجودك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أذل الشرك والمشركين اللهم دمر أعداء الدين اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم أحينا على الإسلام والسنة اللهم أمتنا على الإسلام والسنة اللهم أمتنا على الإسلام والسنة اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في غزة اللهم انصرهم على من بغى عليهم اللهم اجعل لهم من لدنك وليا واجعل لهم من لدنك نصيرا اللهم إنا نعوذ برضاك من سخطك وبمعافاتك من عقوبتك وبك منك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون